Herzlich willkommen zu der 9. Folge von 60s Kilometer. Unsere Helden sind gerade losgezogen, um neue Filter für die Gasmasken zu besorgen bei einer Militärstation. Und jetzt kommt gerade ein Gewitter auf sie zu und ich bin echt gespannt, wie sie das lösen, weil wir festgestellt haben, dass Regen toxisch ist. The silence was broken by a sudden dull rumble. We turned our heads and looked up at the sky. Heavy, dark clouds were approaching us rapidly. There was one more thunder blast, much louder than the previous one. Why haven't I noticed it earlier? If only a drop falls on us, we'll be dead. Don't you remember what happens to water affected by the smoke? I remembered a pond in which we had passed by during our previous trip. So, indeed, how could I forget that? I had seen the thunder cloud when it was far from us. This minor mistake could cost us our lives. Fortunately, our leader decided what to do and took everything in his hands. Follow me, faster. Having said this, he set off and ran. We followed him. Get ready to quickly press the buttons. Ich speichere lieber vorher. So, jetzt muss ich vermutlich wieder Q und E drücken. Ich hab's geschafft. Juhu. I had been good at running at school. I had even won some competitions. Now the skill became dull. We ran as fast as we could. I understood where Alexander Petrovich directed his steps on a high speed. In less than a kilometer in front of us was an old house surrounded by shabby trees. However, I couldn't see them well. It was getting dark quickly. The clouds hit the sun and became darker with shades of pink. Okay, und nochmal Knöpfe drücken und ich speichere vorher nochmal. While running, I lifted up my head. Heavy clouds, which could release drops of toxic liquid at any time, were above our heads. The rain was coming. These clouds could only bring a pouring rain. It was dangerous to stay on the field because we might be struck by lightning, but we were more concerned about the rainfall. Alexander was far ahead from us, of us. We ran much slower, yet we were younger. The building, which could save us, was very close. It was surrounded by old apple trees and a low shabby fence with peeled off paint and a gate in the middle of it. An old woman with a milk can could have come out of it, but there was nobody except us. First drops began falling down. Only a minute was left for us to cover the distance. Drops were falling on the grass. One of them fell on Alexis' shoulder. I saw a hole appeared on his thin jacket, as if it was made by acid. He moaned quietly and kept on running. The second drop fell on my hand. It fell and started going down slowly, leaving a bloody track after it. Toxic fluid came inside. Und nochmal schnell Knöpfe drücken und ich speichere nochmal eine Runde. So, go for it. I just run forward. Was auch sonst. Alexander was almost in front of an open door of the house. Meanwhile, we only reached the gate. One more drop fell on my hand. It felt terrible. I felt terrible pain. A pouring rain started. We came in the house quickly. On my way, I paid attention to a woman's body that lay near the house. One more victim of the pink smoke. Finally, we were out of danger inside the house. Wind started blowing outside. The rain was heavy. Trees bent under the streams of water. The sky was lightened by flashes of lightning. Thunder split our ears. Are you all right? I examined myself. My hand was bleeding. Blood had already fooled my shirt. The wound wasn't big at first sight. Fortunately, I had no more injuries. Alexei's condition was worse. He touched his head. Water ate his ear. His vortex was bleeding. We got into trouble. The wound doesn't seem to be big, but it hurts. I'm going to be bailed. Oleg, will you have a look if it's serious? Okay. Ich würde sagen, der Typ wollte schon mal Suizid begehen. Ob wir jetzt ehrlich zu ihm sind oder nicht. Ich würde sagen, wir sagen ihm, dass es gefährlich ist. Und speichern noch eine Runde. I think it would be better if Alexei goes back to the train when the rain is over. He's hurt most of all. It's not so bad. He can go with us. Yes, Alexander's right. You'd better go back. Dürfte ich vielleicht die Wunde sehen, das zu beurteilen? Naja. Also ich würde sagen, so alleine zurückgehen ist natürlich auch gefährlich, ne? Wenn er sich verläuft oder so. Aber, und wir können eigentlich auch hier mal einen gebrauchen, der mehr trägt. Aber der könnte uns auch aufhalten, also würde ich sagen, er soll lieber zurückgehen. Will you cope without me? Yes, without you we'll bring less useful things, but safety is first of all. We won't risk your life. Okay, when rain is over, I'll go back. What are we going to do? At that moment, a lightning flashed and thunder was heard. Alexander was thinking everything over. I examined our shelter. It was an ordinary old house. An old woman's body with its hands spread lay on the floor. I felt pity for her. Death overtook her unexpectedly. There was a cup with some liquid and a box of chocolate on the table. How did their lives end up? We could only guess what people whom we had seen on our way were doing at the moment when this awful phenomenon took their lives away. Das ist interessant, mal zu fragen, wie lange wir noch Luft haben. Ich glaube, das ist das Wichtigste. Da brauchen wir nicht den Körper und nicht den Tisch erforschen, weil wir sowieso sterben. Also lieber nach der Luft fragen. Wie lange haben wir Zeit? Damit könnten wir auch Panik stiften, aber ich glaube, die beiden sind ruhig genug. So, to be honest, the situation is bad. We have 3 cartridges in reserve. There will be enough for about 50 minutes. While we are waiting here, precious time goes away. We've got only two variants. Und eine Runde speichern. We can go back to the train. There will be enough air for it. But it won't be enough if we go to the military installation and back. There can be no gas masks, so we are taking risk. We risk not only our lives, but the lives of those who stayed in the train. No gas masks, no food. They'll die. Everyone got silent. We looked outside, standing at the door. The sky was clear on the horizon. The rain will last for about 10 minutes. We are lucky. The rain could have lasted longer. We were lucky indeed. Gradually thunder went quiet and the rain was about to stop. I looked at Alexei. He still held his hand on his head, but he didn't want to show us that it hurt. He turned away from us or tried to hide his pain. He was injured the most. Only a couple of drops had fallen on my hands and shoulders. Alexander seemed not to have suffered. Of course, he was the first to reach the house and hide under its roof. He looked at me and noticed I was watching him attentively, then looked at his watch. We'll have to change the cartridges in 15 minutes. The air will be over. With these words, he passed by me and looked outwards. We'll go cautiously in 5 minutes. Now everything's wet. Don't touch anything. He looked at our footwear. We had sneakers. Our leader had high boots. He looked at us discontentedly, but continued his speech. Let's hope that your souls will pass this test. Well. Suddenly the man jumped and went to the next room. Ich würde sagen, wir folgen ihm mal. The room was entered by a typical country bedroom. There was an old bed with numerous pieces of clothes of different colors, which had been used as a sheet, a duvet cover and a pillowcase. Behind the bed there was a table with faded flowers on it. Alexander noticed the cane on the table. He took and examined it. What for have you taken it? This is for saving our lives. The grass is tall and wet. The soles of our boots may protect us from this toxic liquid, but our pants will not protect our legs. The idea was good. I only hesitated if anything was left from grass after the rain. If the rain ate cloth and skin, there should be a little left from plants. This thought came to Alexander and he added quietly, if anything is left on the ground. The rain was over. Last drops fell on the ground, but the water still remained on the roof and trees. Talking about trees. An old apple tree stood near the house. It had got a sight with time, but what happened to it after the rain was awful. There were numerous holes in the leaves as if made by hail. Some leaves fell on the ground. Few of them remained on the tree. I noticed that our leader was shocked by this terrifying view, but it wasn't the only consequence of the rain. Grass, bushes and vegetables all suffered from it. The nature was dying, together with hundreds and thousands of people, still fighting for survival. Trees and other plants, which hadn't been much affected by the catastrophe, started giving up slowly. We waited for a few minutes before setting off. I wish I could felt fresh air after the rain and the subtle smell of ozone. But we could only breathe stuffy air in our gas masks. In a few seconds we went out of the house. The toxic liquid didn't destroy our souls. We went away from the house, which had saved our lives. I tried not to look around. It was hard to see dying nature. Grass under our feet remained its shape and even seemed unaffected. But once we touched it with our boots, it moldered. The world around us was getting gray and gloomy. After the rain, the sky was covered with clouds and sun rays couldn't get through them. Alexander opened the gate with a cane. It was dangerous to touch it. "Well, Alexei, here our ways diverge. Do you remember the route to the train?" "Of course." "Good luck, then." We continued our trip. There was one more house, or its ruins, behind the one which had protected us from the rain. It was seen that the building had been burned recently. I even imagined how it had happened. The toxic smoke caught people unexpectedly. Maybe at that moment something had been cooked on the stove, or an iron had been switched on, or there could be anything. What about factories and other enterprises, which were controlled by people every minute? The amount of different accidents could be enormous, taking into account that I didn't know the scale of the catastrophe. We went out of a narrow road leading from the small houses to the thicket of tall grass. Bulrush could be seen in front of us. There was a military. Where was a military man leading us? "A bog is onwards. It will be dangerous. It's not big, but one wrong step can cost us alive. We can't bypass it. It will take about 50 minutes, and it won't be enough air. We'll have to risk. I'll go first. Be careful and follow my steps." I nodded. When our leader, who went in front of me, undrew the thicket of bulrush, it broke, fell into pieces, and set it down. He made an insecure step, then one more. I followed him. Slowly, irresolutely, we were moving forward. Ich glaube, es kommen Quicktime Events. The cane was used not only for cleaning the road from tall and wet bog grass, but also for testing if a step could be made without falling in the water. Sometimes we had to jump from one hill rock to another. A fence and a couple of buildings, one which resembled a storage, could be seen in the distance. Oder keine Quicktime Events, auch gut. Perhaps it was our destination. Suddenly Alexander Petrovich stopped and mumbled something, but I didn't hear what exactly. He started touching the ground in front of him with a cane. In every place where he poked his cane, it sank in the water. He pulled it out quickly, not to lose it, because the water was eating it slowly. He squatted, stretching out his hand continuously and moved it down once again. The cane didn't sink in the water, but touched solid ground. He checked once again. if it wasn't dangerous to step there. He looked at me, gave me the cane and jumped forward. He was about to fall, but maintained his footing. Then he looked at us, anticipatingly, and waved his hand. Aber warum us? Ich glaube, das ist einfach nur schlecht geschrieben, weil man hatte die Möglichkeit, ihn nach Hause zu schicken oder nicht, und da wurde es jetzt Wort nicht geändert. Krasser Fehler in dem Spiel und so. Düdüm. Naja, gut. Oder ist der Typ noch bei uns? Nee, dann müsste er eigentlich in eine andere Richtung weggegangen sein, oder? Naja, gut. I gave him the cane back and waited for him to clean the road near the place where he was standing. I had to jump. It was slippery under my feet. But I, having waited for some time, moved forward and jumped. Like Alexander, I was about to slip, but maintained my footing. The hard part was left behind. Who knows what will happen to us at the military installation? But we had to fight not only for our lives, but for the lives of those who waited for us there, at the 60th kilometer of the Moscow Railway south direction. Speichern. Das Ende von Kapitel 6. Und da wir auch schon wieder 20 Minuten dabei sind, würde ich sagen, beende ich an dieser Stelle diese Folge. Und wenn ihr wissen wollt, wie es in Kapitel 7 weitergeht, ob die an die Gasmasken tatsächlich rankommen, dann schaut doch einfach die nächste Folge. Bis dahin. Tschüss.